Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to make cabbage pakoda. So these are all the ingredients which we are going to use for this. Is just like, you know, you can see there's so less of ingredients, just the cabbage which is the major ingredient. And so during this time when we are all kind of house arrested, it's a good time to have this like something to munch on all the time. So let's make this pakora, and you can have it with tea as a snack, or you can also have it, you know, as a part of the manchurian recipe also. You can make the cabbage pakora and then make a manchurian out of it as well. So yeah, let's dive into the video. So first let us go into the ingredients, what one by one, what all we will be requiring. As you can see already, this is just like the cabbage is a major ingredient. And so here is a cabbage which is very very finely chopped. And apart from that, we have basin here, and this is red chili powder. You can also replace red chili powder with the green chilies, finely chopped green chilies. This is little turmeric, this is kalonji. You can also use ajwin in place of kalonji. It's completely up to you, the kind of smell or kind of flavor which you want, and the salt according to your taste. So what we'll be doing initially is that we'll be mixing the water with this basin to make it into a semi-liquidy kind of consistency, and we'll be putting the whole cabbage, that is a finely chopped cabbage, inside this, so that water with the basin and this cabbage gets mixed up really really well with all these other ingredients as well. All of this will be going into this bowl with the water and making it into a very semi-liquidy kind of consistency. Then we will be diving into how to fry it. So let's start by mixing the water. So now what we are doing is that we are adding water as per required to make it into a semi-liquidy kind of consistency, and then we'll be mixing all of it together. So this is the kind of consistency that we are looking at. So you see, this is not like, you know, not runny, not like very tight also. So this is the kind of consistency. Now as this batter is completely done, what we'll be doing is that we'll be taking a kadai in which we'll be putting a lot like oil to deep fry it, and then we'll be putting it one by one. Now that I have put the kadai on the stove, so what I'll be doing is that now I'll be adding the water after this, you know, the water, whatever there is in the kadai gets, you know, dried up. I'll be adding the water like in optimum quantity so that it gets deep fried. So I'll be showing you the quantity of the oil as well. So you see, this is the quantity of the oil. This is like 7 to 8 full spoons of oil that I have put. So I have put it in the high flame. So let the water like you know, get warmed up, and then we'll be putting this this batter one by one into this round like you know, shapes, so that it gets fried in the pakora type of thing. So now what we are doing is that we'll be putting one by one this things into the oil, that now the oil has warmed up. In this shape or whatever shape you like. If you like it in a little thicker format also, you can do it that way. Now you can put as many as your kadai is able to accommodate. Here I'll be putting like around 4 to 5, because I have like a flat base kind of a kadai. And put the flame on the high flame only, so that it gets fried well. So this is how it looks like when I have put all these things in the kadai. So now it is like fried in the one side, and I am just flipping it on the other side so that the both the sides gets fried up. I had put like, you know, 4 pakoras in the kadai. You can you know, put as many as you can accommodate in the kadai, and that once both the sides are fried up well, you just drain out the oil from them very nicely, and then it is almost done. Now that both side is fried, what I'll be doing is that I'll be putting it into this draining the bowl. So as side is being done already, I am putting it into the equipment in which you can you know, drain it out, drain the completely oil out, and once it is drained out, just it is completely done. So that is how it will look like. So yeah, this is my completely this cabbage pakoda which is done already, and that is how it looks. It's a really tasty and yummy recipe with you know, you can make it in no time, and you can have it with tea, some snacks, or you can mix it with puffed rice and have it as a side dish. Or you can also make a manchurian out of the fried thing that the pakoda is being done. So now you can make the gravy and put this pakoda, break it and put into the manchurian gravy, and it will be a manchurian dish altogether. So yeah, that's all about my today's video. Hope you enjoyed it, and you know, you can make it during this time when you have a lot of time in your hand, and you always, of course, when we all are at home, we always do have this feeling of we should be munching on something. So that's it about today. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and also press the bell icon for notification of my subsequent uploads. Bye bye, take care, stay tuned.